Requirement I think I have given you, right? So you create a customer form. Did I give you any requirement? We have not given, right? Okay, just write down the requirement. But I told you about what is flow, what is section, what is flow action, basic definitions I have told you, right? Write down. Everyone just make a note of this one. How to create user interface. And make it part of transaction processing. How to create user interface and make it part of transaction processing. Right up. Create a new user interface form. Create a new user interface form to capture basic customer details. To capture basic customer details. Okay, this is the requirement that we are going to work on. So simple UI to capture basic customer details. So when I say basic customer details, what are the properties here?
First name, last name, state.
Yeah, the basic properties. That's why I didn't tell you about properties and all to note down, because you're already aware of these basic things. But other than this, if any other screen that we're going to design has specific properties which you're not aware of, I'll give you complete details about property and its definition, everything. So let's proceed now and work on this. As a first step, we are going to create properties. So if you want to design user interface, in the last class document, did I give you anything related to
no.
This is understanding basic. Yeah, this is the right, creating UI and vision part of the process. These are the steps that we need to perform. Okay, so if you wanted to go ahead and create user interface, as we have already discussed in the last class, we have to create UI. First of all, we need to identify and create all the required properties, and then create a section, drag and drop all the above properties into the layouts of section, creating a flow action and getting the section added into flow action, and finally creating a flow and adding this flow action into flow. Up to this we had discussed, and we didn't discuss about the fifth point, whatever that I have written here, which I'll tell you later. It is apply the feature of creating work object to the above flow. Whatever the flow that we create, we are going to apply some feature to create a work object, and then we can go ahead and execute the flow. That we are going to practically see, and then I'll explain. So first thing is, we are going to create properties. So if you want to create properties, what is the category under which we can create properties?
Data model.
Properties can be created under data model category. But before you proceed forward and create, you have certain things to identify. So business will not tell you in which class you have to create all this. Suppose here, if you see, we have organization class and we have namespace class and we have work class. You can, while you are creating any rule, you have to create the rules in some of the classes. But in which class you should create, business will not tell you technically. Create it in top level or somewhere. But based on the business requirement only, you should be able to understand. Generally, in the requirement, you should be able to identify what is the scope of the component that you are going to create in your application processing. Suppose generally you take a customer form. Suppose you have different implementations in your application, a number of different implementations. Is this customer form same for all different implementations? Is
no.
This going to be same?
No.
Basic customer details form.
Is the customer, yeah, it might be.
it should be same, right? Basic form means I'm not going to add any specific properties related to specific transaction types, but we need to collect the person details. Okay, like first name, last name, age, gender, what is the address, like this we wanted to capture the basic details. Any type of business means a number of different classes that you have, all the classes can use the same type of properties. So in okay. that case, in okay. which class we should need to create these properties? In which class we should have to create?
Organization.
Is it in the work class or is it in the namespace class or organization class?
Organization.
We have to create in organization class. So why we need to create in organization class? The reason being, it is common across your entire business. In your business, wherever you go, if you want to capture customer details, same type of properties, same form you have to use. So everything that we are going to create now, we will be creating in organization class. Okay, let's go ahead and create this in organization class. Why we need to create in organization class?
Reusable.
Create all the required roles in organization class. I'm going to do right here. You're not required to write all this. Create all the required roles in organization class. What is the reason? Because
it can be reused across.
This is common across entire business. Entire business, this form is common. So we will create in organization class. So if you want to create properties in any class, the navigation, just let me show you first. After that, I'll give you the screenshot. You need to right click on class. So it doesn't mean you have to right click on this class. You can right click anywhere. It's up to you. So right click on any class, create data model, and then this is the navigation to choose to create a property. Property under which category? Data model category. The second menu, what you see is called category menu, and third menu is role type. Role categories, role types. And here you have to provide a label to the property, first name, and tab out identifier is the actual name. So we need to understand these parameters. I'm going to talk about these parameters later. This parameter, I'll talk about it later. Only first, as of now, I'll be telling you this parameter applies to. Apply to means in which class you want to create this property. See, if you right click on any class, by default, apply to will be filled with the class on which you have right clicked. But still, if you want to create in a different class than where you have right clicked, you can backspace it and choose the class whatever that you wanted to create. So I want to create in which class? ARBA class. So I have to choose ARBA class. Apply to means exactly in which class you want to create this group. I want to create this property in ARBA class. That's why I have chosen ARBA class. Now, context means we have how many applications? Pega platform. In Pega platform, you cannot create any applications. UI kit is something additional added in Pega 7.2.2 onwards. This is also OTP, already available. So no need to bother about these two as of now. Let's go ahead and talk about these two contexts. Here context means application context. In which application context you want to create this form? Is it specific to one implementation or it is specific? It is common across multiple implementations. So customer form is common across multiple implementations or specific to one implementation? Common across multiple implementations. So the context can go ahead with implementation or framework. Framework. That is how you need to identify in which context that you wanted to go ahead and create your application, your roles. I'm sorry. This is application context in the role form. And this is the class in which you want to create. This rule set and all, I'll tell you later. But as of now, what you have to do is, you have to follow to choose whatever that I've chosen in the screenshot, the same way you have to choose in your application. So mostly for a few days, these two will be same. If you see the rule set name and class name, both will be same for some time. So you can just remember that and follow it while creating, okay? So let's create all these rules. In framework application context, suppose if I create in framework application context, should I be able to access that in implementations. Okay, now tell me reverse. Suppose if I create something in framework application context, should I be able to access that in implement? I'm sorry. If I create something in implementation application context, should I be able to access that into framework?
No.
That is not possible because implementation is child of framework. It is just a parent-child relation. Let's create all the rules in framework application context and organization, class and role set. But you don't know what is rule set. For few days, you just follow me. Okay, choosing the rule set and all. So right click on where. You have to right click on some class. That class can be ARBE class. That class can be any class. But after you right click whatever the form that you are going to get, in that form, you have to change the apply to class. Okay, suppose if I backspace it simply and directly choose here ARBA class. So if I right click on ARBA and choose create data model and then property, then apply to by default, you'll get whichever the class on which you have right clicked on. But still, it is editable or not? It is editable. So where you right click doesn't matter, but what you choose in this apply to drop down is something which we need to bother about. This is clear, everyone? So wherever you want to right click, you can right click on any class. Okay, let's go ahead. Suppose if you want this class to be accessible every time, you can just click on this pin so that it will be added into pinned classes. So you're not required to navigate this way and that way. Every time when you log into your application, VRPC loads class group. It will not load organization class separately. It will always load class group. In order to access ARBE and what is there in the ARBE, you need to backspace it up to here and then choose enter to access. Once if you do that, next time, once if you do it and you just pin it, next time onwards, if you want to access, you're not required to go back. From here also, you can access. It's just adding a shortcut of what you wanted to access. Okay. Let's go ahead and create properties now. So let me choose this ARBE class here and pin it. Okay, I'm not going to talk about the screenshots related to choosing ARBE. Creating first property. What is the first property? First name. So here I'm going to create a property called first name. So this is the navigation. Right click on the class, data model, property. And here you go ahead with the form, whatever that you have got. Here you need to specify the label. What is the label? First name. So first space name, this is just a display name. If you tab out, you see first name is coming, removing that white spaces. This is the actual name of the property. Okay. And here you go with context. We want it to be framework context. Choose the application context. Context. Framework. Remaining two, look at here once. This one I'm going to choose framework. Framework. And once you choose it, automatically the rule set is changed. Previously it was different, now it is different. So whatever that you have got by default, you just leave it. As we didn't discuss about this rule set and all, as of now, you can blindly follow just with whatever that has been prefilled there. Suppose if I have implementation previously, it was something different actually. It was like this. Once I change it to framework, it has been updated to the same name as organization. That is called organization rule set. We will talk about it later. So here you go with the context, whatever that we have chosen. I think I've given the screenshot right above. This is what the context I've chosen. Now click on the button, create and open. So there is a button called create and open. If you see top right side, click on create and open. So once you click on create and open, here you see property type. What is the property type? Property type for first name, what it could be? Text property. By default, whatever the property type that you have got, okay, that is fine for you. Suppose if you want a different property type, you can click on change and choose something different. And the control is also text input control. So whatever that we have got, we can accept the defaults. Accept the defaults for property type and what is the other one? And control. So click on save. Once you click on save, the moment you click on save, then property gets created. Till now, so far, property is not yet been created. Just you are in process of creating this property. See, once you click on save, you will get a delete button here. You got delete button means it has been created. Now look at here. You can close this. Suppose if I want to see this property, in which class I can see this property? Organization class. If you right click on organization class and choose refresh, then only it will get loaded. Otherwise, it will not be loaded. Just to see this property in the class, organization class and refresh it. Okay, look at here. This is the navigation to refresh. Every time once you create, it will not be automatically available in the left side. Okay, if you refresh it, it will be available. Now you see data model and then property. You have that property coming here. If you click on this property name, first name, you will see the property type is text and other things. Everything is editable here except property type. Once we create property, we cannot modify property type. See, once we create property, we cannot modify property type. We cannot modify it. In any technology you go and see, it is same. Okay, you cannot modify the property type. If you want to modify, you have to delete it and then create again with the same name of different type. And before you delete it, you need to find out all the references and then accordingly again you have to refer the new property, modify it accordingly. So first name property is ready. Similarly, create all other properties. So let me go ahead and create all other properties here. So right click on the class, create data model and then property. This is the last time I'm going to give you the navigation to create property. Going forward, I'll not give this navigation. So last name is also similar to first name. Every other option, whatever that I have got, I'm just fine with the options, whatever that is preferred. Save this. Done. Next property. What is the next property? I'm creating another property called age. Create data model property. This navigation I'm not going to give. This one, age. And here, age property of what type? Age, I'm going to choose it to be. You have integer somewhere. So before I choose integer, look at here. Your property type text and what is the control? PX text input. Once we change it to integer, what happened? Control got updated automatically to PX integer. So PX integer also like text input only. Appearance like text box, but when you enter any text value other than integer value, if you enter, it will automatically throw error message. That is already been handled. So save this. So this text input box only accepts integer values. Age after, I'm going to create gender property. So next property what I'm going to create is create data model property, and here you go with gender. So property type is text or not. Gender male, female, this is text only. But control, change the control to radio buttons. Change the control to radio buttons. So there is a prefix before every control like PX, PY, something will be there, which I'll tell you later. What is the, if you click the down arrow, you will see all available controls. It will be difficult for you to identify radio button control where it is available in the list. Instead, what you do is just backspace it and type something like READ and click the down arrow. The matching content will be highlighted. so that it will be easy for you to identify the respective control. So radio button is the one which I wanted to choose. So once I choose radio buttons, choose table type local list. Choose table type local list to add some values to radio buttons. So how many radio buttons you wanted to get, everything will be based on this local list, whatever that we are going to choose now. So once you add local list, by default you'll get a text input here to add the local list values. Gender, I want to add male, and one more row I want, that is female. This is clear, everyone? If you want to add more values, you just add and see, you'll get more number of radio buttons with different values, whatever that you're going to add. Just let me go ahead and save this. Completed. So gender is completed. Next, state. So one more property that I wanted to create is state. See, you can go to action drop down here in a property and choose create. This is also another navigation to create a property. You can right click on data model directly instead of class, data model, all that. Directly right click on data model and choose create property. This is also okay. Any navigation that you wanted to follow, you can follow. So sometime you follow the basic navigation. What is this? State, right? State. And this property, what I am going to create here, I want it to be a drop down. UI kit is not required, Sushmana. No scenario. If you want to create something related to your user interface rules in Pega defined application, you'll go for UI kit. Everything is same, and the control is drop down control I'm choosing. Local list, and what are the values that you wanted to enter here? Is first value I want it to be select, and click on plus icon and add one more value. Some states that I remember, that I know, you can add whatever the states that you wanted to add. Something like this, you can add more number of states if you wanted to add. As of now, for testing purpose, I'm adding only a few states. Next, city. Create city similar to first name, like text input only. But as of now, we're not going to add any drop down values and dependency, like based on state, populating only specific cities. This and all we'll be practically working on later. But as of now, let's create city also like a text input. Later, we will be updating this to a drop down, which is been automatically getting filtered based on the previous state value, whatever that you select. As I'm not going to implement it now, and as you need to acquire more knowledge about the same, so we will be doing it later. That's why I'm as of now creating this as a text input. City after, next property is zip code. I'm going to create. So zip code, when you create, it is this one is also same. Zip code may start with zero, so better you go with text input, same. Next, email address. One more property called email address. So this email address property, text property, control is email. Something control is there related to email. You can proceed with that email control, which will accept the specific format for the email. All the properties are created. If you want to see all these properties, what is that you can do is, you can simply right click here and do refresh. You should see all the properties pinned here in the pinned class here. Property, and here I go over. These are the properties created. So these are the properties that are being created. So all the properties are created. We can use everything OOTP. We will be using OOTP properties, OOTP UI rules and all, maybe sometime later. As of now, we'll learn how to create everything from the scratch. Next, what we should create, second one, create section. For user interface design, we We need section. Section can be created under which category? User interface category. So what is the navigation to create section? So right click on this class name, create user interface, and then section. So you follow the practice that I'm going to tell you now. What is the name of the section? This UI is used to capture customer details. That's why I'm mentioning the name as a customer details. SEC is the naming convention that I'm following. If you wanted to, if you do not want to give an SEC, you can, it's up to you. Some naming conventions usually every organization follows. Once you join any project, if you open few of the rules and see the names, you'll be able to understand what is the naming convention that they're following. Based on functionality and other aspects, they'll use specific naming convention. So accordingly, you can follow. So create and open now. And here you go with. See, when you create a section, by default, you'll get a layout, which is an empty layout. Why is it just taking too much time? Okay. You'll get an empty layout like this. So what it says, drag any number of properties or other sections or any UI elements or any layouts here. Don't bother about other things, only bother about properties. Drag any number of properties here into the layout. So what is that you can do is, you can go ahead and just simply get all the properties, drag and drop here. So here you go with properties. These are the properties. Drag and drop the properties into the layout. Drag and drop the properties into the layout. Let me go ahead and drag and drop those properties. What is the order that you want? You have to drag and drop. See, in order to drag and drop the property, beside every property name, before every property name, you have small six dots available, right? So you need to place your cursor on this small six dots and then pick with your mouse and drag this. And once it is coming here, just release it. So if you release here, it will add accordingly the control and all. Suppose if you try to drag and drop outside of this layout, what is happening? Read only something. So you have to drag and drop inside the layout. Drag and drop all the properties inside the layout. Suppose if you take any property, on the property name, if you pick the property and then try to drag and drop, it will not come. So where you need to pick the property? So before the property, you have six dots, right? Just drag and drop, picking that six dots. Okay, first name property, drag and drop the properties here into the layout. This is first name property. What is the next one? Last name. Once it is highlighted in saffron color, you can release that last name. Similarly, what is next? First name, last name, gender, age, state, city, where is it? Zip code, and you can go out with email address. Email address like this. You have all the properties, simply drag and drop here onto the ground. Now align the controls. Align the controls. So if you wanted to go ahead and align the controls, you need to double click on layout. So look at here. Here you go with, this is the layout, right? To double click on the layout. Double click on layout can be done like this, simply. If you double click, it will show you a pop-up. Okay, everyone clear, right? And here you go with layout format. What is the layout format? Based on the layout format, whatever that you choose here, the alignment will happen. Suppose if I choose inline grid triple and submit, you see three columns. Suppose if I choose inline grid double, how many columns now? Two columns and number of rows. So we'll go ahead and choose inline grid double as of now. You can just play around with these options choosing. Inline grid double or triple is up to you. Just save this. So far section is not created. Once you save, it will be created. Once it is created, you see a delete button. Only when you see delete button, that means it is created. Done. So if you want to see the section now, suppose let me close here. If you want to see the section in the class, what we should do now? Right click and then choose. Refresh this ARB. You will get user interface category. expand this user interface category section, this is the section. If you click on this section, now if you wanted to remove something or if you wanted to add something, you can do that. Select this, and here you have delete button, right? If you click on delete, it will be deleted. You can try it once if you want to try. Okay, this is the section created. What is next that we need to create? Create flow action. So let me go ahead and create a flow action now. Here go with, right click on the class and choose create process category and then choose flow action. This is the navigation to create a flow action because it is under process category. So what is the name of the flow action? This flow action is going to hold a section which is customer details section. So I'm giving the flow action name is customer details FA. FA naming convention means flow action. You give it, you are going to mention it or not is up to you. So this is how a flow action looks like. Now call the section into flow action. See, if you want to call the section into flow action, so here you see section, right? This is a drop down. If you click the down arrow here, you see all available sections that you have created in the same class or parent classes. So as of now, how many classes we have? How many sections we have? We have only one section in the current class, that is what visible here. So you are not required to manually type the names of the sections that you have created. Instead, you can just click on the down arrow and choose it from the drop down so that there won't be any mistakes in the names and all. Just simply save it. There is a lot of functionality behind this flow action. We'll be learning all other functionalities later. As of now, it is only just including section inside a flow action. This is clear. So like this, going forward, we are going to create different screens: address information screen, vehicle details screen, personal vehicles, commercial vehicles, transaction details, agency details, policy details, and loss details. Like this, there are a number of screens in our complete transaction, which we are going to design. But it is not everything in one day. It will take some time, actually. So it's not only user interface that we are going to complete all at one single go and then work on other stuff. We'll be working on everything combinedly. So today we have worked on this, maybe second screen, and we'll work on business logic, database and all. We integrate everything. So like this, we are going to enhance our application going forward to add more number of steps into your transaction processing. Okay, so while learning Pega at the same time. So here you go with, this has been saved. So your flow action is created. If you want to see the flow action here, you can right click on this and refresh. And here you go with process category and flow action and click on the flow action. Suppose you wanted to remove this section and I wanted to add different one. If you have, you can just remove it here, click the down arrow and choose a different section. Okay, let's go ahead now and create a flow. Now create a flow, fourth step, right? So I'm going to create a flow now. So what is the name of the flow that I wanted to give here is simply customer details flow as of now. This is the temporary flow that I'm going to create. Otherwise, you can, yeah, I wanted to create the flow name is customer details FL flow. Customer details flow that I wanted to create. Here I go with, this is how by default a flow diagram that you get. So that is with the start shape, end shape. Tell me what is the in-between flow shape? Assignment shape. What is the primary purpose of assignment shape? To call a flow action into flow. Without that, you cannot save the assignment of flow. Okay. So now, where do we call the flow action into workflow using assignment shape? So here, we can call flow action into assignment shapes where outboard connector, that is where we have a facility to call flow action. So now what we can do is double click on assignment shape outboard connector. So directly on the assignment shape, this option will not be available for process flows. Now here I'm going to double click on, this is outboard connector, right? Double click on this outboard connector. When you double click on the outboard connector, you will see a pop-up like this. So mostly entire PRPC is like this only. You double click somewhere and you get pop-ups and choose from the drop-downs. Somewhere you choose drag and drop like this, okay? So you need to understand the navigations initially after long complete navigation. So by default, you see flow action name is same as flow name. But do we have any flow action name with this? we don't have. You remove this and click the down arrow. You see the flow action which you have created. This is the flow action which we have created. Click the down arrow. You should see that. So select it, and this flow action name, you can copy this and you can paste in the label. This is the label for the connector. If you are not specifying anything here in the workflow diagram, look at here, you will not see any label for the connector. Suppose if I'm going to copy the same and paste here, remove this and just paste here, and now you submit, you will see that label is coming on the connector, so that a developer will understand the flow action name without opening it. Okay, so just double click on this, and this is what you have to do, but that is not mandatory to give the flow action in there. And here just submit this, and you see here the assignment name says similar to flow name by default. The assignment label, this is just a label, it will not have any impact in the processing and all, just for developer understanding. What is the purpose of this assignment? To collect the customer information, right? So the label of the assignment you can change meaningfully. Change the label of assignment. So how to change it? Just simply you single click on this label. Single click on the label, you can remove it. Now write down whatever you want. So collect customer info. If you're going to do like this, collect customer info, what happens now? When next developer, whenever he come and see this, okay, using this assignment shape, they're collecting customer information. That means this flow action is for collecting customer information so that it makes some better sense to the developers. But other than that, until you implement it by yourself, it will not have any impact during the process, okay? Now, the fourth step is done. Step five, add a feature to the above flow to create work object. But you don't know what is work object and all. Okay, I'll tell you in some time, but as of now, go to process tab. Go to process tab. Let me go and write down the same. Go to process tab of above flow. So this is the process tab here. And here is the flow. Previously you were in diagram tab. Now we go to process tab, and here creates a new work object. There is a checkbox option available. Select this creates a new work object. But you don't know why you are selecting this as of now, because I didn't tell you. Okay. Okay, I'm sorry, hang on. I'll first give you without this, without selection. Select creates a new work object. This is the option that we need to go ahead and select. I'm going to select this. I'll highlight this and give you the next screenshot, and then save this. Then completed. So now once you save this, this is where you are. Don't bother about the warning messages that you're getting. We'll talk about the warnings later. So now execute the flow using action dropdown. Look at here. This is the flow, and here you have action dropdown. Click on action dropdown and choose run. Okay, let me go ahead and write down the same. Click on action button and choose run. So here you go. Once you click on action menu, and here you have option called run, choose this. Oh, one more option. Oh, I'm sorry. I have made some mistake. Okay, let me tell you. So here it says this object cannot be written to the database. There is something other than that. Okay, see, simply this flow, even though you are going to run it, it will not create any business transactions. What is the reason? Sorry? No, what is the reason? This flow, you should not be able to use it for creating transactions, initiation of your transaction, creation of your transaction cannot be done using this flow. What is the reason? Because this flow I created in this class, organization class. Organization class is of what type of class? Abstract class. Abstract classes, we can create something, I mean like here like flows. Can we initiate our business transactions? That's why you got that error message. Okay. Anyway, there is another step also which I have to make. I will change the screenshot of flow creation. Just hang on. Only that screenshot I'm changing, but will you be getting confused with other screenshot class names? Okay, now create a flow here. Create flow in work class. Flow you have to create in work class. Work class is a concrete class. So the navigation to create a flow is create sysadmin, create process and then flow. This navigation I have already given you. This screenshot I'll change. What is this flow name? Customer details FL. And what should be the class here? Applies to work class. So you will not be getting by default in the drop down. So we will be creating this in framework work class or implementation work class. Where do you want to create? You want to create an implementation. Okay, let's proceed with implementation. ARB hyphen. Okay, I'll click on view all so that you can see all the classes here. Click the down arrow. This is framework and this is implementation. You want to create an implementation? Let's go ahead and create an implementation. It's up to you. Okay, if you want to create in framework, you can create in framework. Okay, let's go ahead and choose screen print and say, okay, let me give the screenshot clearly. Let me change this screenshot. I'm creating in implementation work class. Okay, and here you go where? Hey, how come it? Okay, if it is implementation work class, for framework application, implementation work will not be visible. Okay, suppose if that's why you are not getting any rule sets here. Suppose if I choose implementation, then it will be loaded. Implementation application can see implementation level or top level. Framework cannot see below implementation classes. So which class will select here? We'll select FW class, framework work class. So then you will see the next rule sets and all you'll be getting. So as of now, you can follow this to select only framework application and framework classes. So once you choose framework classes, it looks like this. Now you can proceed forward, create and open. I'll change the screenshots. I'm deleting this one. The one which I have created in organization, I don't need it actually. So I'll delete it later. This is how you got it previously. Otherwise you'll get confused. If I'm not going to change the screenshots, you'll get confused. Okay, this is how we got. Now double click on this flow shape. Let me do that screenshots. Here you go, double click on this. After you double click on, I'll give a screenshot. And after this, I copied this and added it here. Yeah, this is the submit option. After submit option, okay, I'll give in between one more screenshot of choosing that from the dropdown. That you are going to choose it from dropdown. So it makes sense that you should be selecting this from the dropdown. Okay, after you submit, this is what you are going to get. Later we updated the label, right? Change the assignment label to collect customer info, something like this. I have updated. And after this, I it is completed. Next, we go to process tab of the flow. And look at here. I'm going to process tab of the flow, and here I'm choosing. I wanted to give this screenshot. Select creates a new work object checkbox, right? This is the one which I have to modify. Select this. And apart from this, there is another option which I forgot to tell you, which you need to choose. As of now, you can blindly follow this. I will tell you in a few minutes. Okay. So the other option is scroll down and work parties is there, right? So here I go and scroll down. Change the work party option from default to PY case management default. This is the option. Why we have to change, I will tell you in a few minutes. Okay, remove this. PY case management default is there in the drop down. You are not required to manually type that. You have to choose it from the drop down. I'll cover all this in some time today. Now execute the flow using action drop down, but before that you need to make sure you're going to save it. So I saved it. So now you can go to action drop down and then run this flow. The screenshot also I'll change. Otherwise you will get confused. Okay, now you will not face any issues. It will be successfully been executed. The reason being, it is there in concrete classes. Previously you got error message because that is in abstract class. So once you run this, enter some test data. Look at here, I can go and enter some data here. Gender, age, some state and city, zip code and email address. Submit this. Did we create any submit button? But we are able to submit this. This information gets stored in backend database table. This information gets stored in backend table, which you call it as work table. Generally, we call it a work table, but we'll talk about that later. This is basically how you can go out and design UI and simply add it into the workflow and then execute the workflow. You can enter the information and submit. So before we proceed to talk about the database, where this data gets stored and all, first we need to understand about this option of creates a new work object, all this. Okay, just for your information, let me go ahead and PY case management default option. Okay, that one. Work parties, right? Work parties. PY case management default. Let me create a new document. $565, right? Why did we choose PY case management default option? As of now, this is functional. Technical, we will be learning later. Why did we choose PY case management default option in workflow under work parties? FR work parties. What is work party and all, I'm not going to discuss now, but what is the reason that I have changed this option, I'm going to tell you. Okay. Now you see here, this is the actual option that we are talking about. This is the option that we were talking about. Suppose to understand this functionally, we will change this option back to, what it was before. What it was? Default. Change this option back to default. Let me change it. Remove this and change it to default. I have changed it. Save this. So now run the flow. So click on this save and just go ahead and run the flow. Now let's see what is happening. You know how to run the flow. Did we create this screen? Do we need this screen anymore? See, this screen, whatever that we have got, we did not create this screen. And we don't even need this screen as of now. So where is this coming from? This is a default screen. It is called as new harness, but you don't bother about the technical terminology new harness as of now, which we'll be learning later. This is a default screen provided by Pega, which gets loaded when we run any flow. So here you go, it is getting automatically loaded. If you want to proceed forward from here, you need to click on delete icon and then click on done. You will be proceeded forward to actual screen, whatever that you want. Okay. So click on delete icon and click on done button. Now we got our customer details screen. We can make use of the other screen what we have seen now, but we'll be using it later. So as of now, I don't need the screen what is being displayed by default. So now you change the option back. This is our test case that we have executed. Now change the work parties option to PY case management default. Let's change it. Where is it? Work parties, remove this and click the down arrow. I've changed it. PY case management default. Save, run. Let me complete first. Actions, and you go ahead and run this. So once you run, what did you get now? Now, what is this option all about as of now? You tell me what is this all about? The PY case management default. When we select work parties, PY case management default, what is happening? The display of initial screen. I'll say this is initial screen. Actually, it is called new harness. Yeah, the display of initial screen is being, what happened? Ignored. So the display of initial screen is being ignored. It is directly loading our flow action. What is that we are expecting as of now? So in order to avoid this screen, I am just selecting. This is functionally I'm talking about all these things. In order to avoid displaying new harness, we have chosen what? PY case management default for work parties. If you have not chosen, what would have happened? That initial screen would have been displayed. Unnecessarily, you have to complete that form and then proceed forward, which I do not want at all. Later, we will be using that screen when we work with other business requirements. That time, I'll tell you how we can make use of it. But as of now, we don't need it actually. What is your question? We have a question offline, just hang on. Work parties, yes. Yes. Click on done, proceed forward. We didn't get. We click on delete and then click on done, you will get your screen. That means it is an additional screen which you got in between your screen and your transaction initiation. No, it will not change. Every time you run the flow, if you have default option, every time you run the flow, that new screen will be displayed. Okay, if you change it to PY case management default, that screen display will be ignored. After you delete and proceed forward, you will get your own screen, but options will not change there in the backend, in the flow. Okay, so this is just a functional aspect. What is the reason I am selecting that? I have told you, but I didn't tell you what is the work part is technically. Okay, we'll discuss that later. Let's proceed now. Everyone clear with this option? Why I have chosen? Okay, this is just a behavior option.
Sorry, yes. Harsha. If it is avoiding new harness, so the harness that which is shown, is it confirm harness or is it something different?
Which one?
So when we selected PY case management default, which harness is it showing? If it is avoiding new harness, what is the harness that is displayed?
For your information, that is perform harness. But we are not going to talk about harnesses and all later. That's why I didn't use technical terminology much. I'm telling new screen, some new screen. That's all. We'll be working on understanding all harnesses later. It's a different topic.
Okay.
But for your information, as of now, that is perform harness. But you don't bother about what is harness and all other resources. Yeah. Sushma, you should be. Yeah, if you go through screenshots, you will understand. But I don't know where you have missed it. But let me talk about creating new work object checkbox. Yes, please.
Arsha, one question. In a property, in a section, so we are drag and dropping a properties, right? Can we change? I mean, is there how we can change the order of the properties?
Sorry, how it is?
We can change the order of the properties because initially
suppose, I'll talk about creates a new work object option tomorrow. See, Sushma, if you have missed it from creates a new work object, I told you right already there was a video available in YouTube channel, old video. One can watch it if you have missed this one, but it should not happen every day. Remember that, because all videos will not be available. Suppose if you come here, by mistake you have added properties in a different order than what you are expecting. If you want to change the order, you can click on this particular cell, whichever that you wanted to move. Pick this with your mouse and then move it simply. Just move it, it will be coming in a different order. Wherever you wanted to move it to, you can change it. Like the order will be changed. If you want to change it, you're not required to delete and do it. State, city, zip code. After zip code, I want email address, right? Okay, so you can just drag and drop this way and that way. So creates a new work object checkbox. I'll tell you later. You have any questions here? Okay, let me summarize what we have done. Simply, we created properties and added properties into section, section into flow action into flow. After that, we came here, process tab. We have chosen the option creates a new work object and scroll down. We have chosen an option called work parties with PY case management default. Before it was by default, default. So the reason why I have chosen is functional behavioral reason. That is, if I have not chosen this option to be PY case management default, I am getting a new screen, actually, which I am not expecting in my transaction processing. If you want to avoid that, you have to choose it. Otherwise, there is no need to choose it. The screen which you got by default, if you want to customize, you can customize. That and all we'll be learning in future classes while we are working with harness. Maybe it will take 1 month. 1 month or 1 month, 10 days. This is clear. So now this creates a new work object option. If I have to tell you, it will take some time because it will take around 1 hour. The tomorrow class, I'll explain you these points. Like the option creates a new work object, how it will be helping the workflow to create transactions. And after you initiate the transaction, the screen that gets displayed, you are going to enter the data and submit. Exactly what is happening in the background before the screen gets displayed. Okay, what do you mean by work object? And after you submit it, in which table in the backend data is getting stored? How PRPC exactly identifies the table to store this work object and all when there are n number of tables available in backend? So while you are installing Vega, you would have seen, right? there are multiple tables are getting loaded, database created, table loading, data getting inserted, these many records created. That means there are many tables available in the backend. Out of all those tables, it has to specifically identify only one table to store these transactions what we have created now. How it is going to identify the exact table to store the transactions? This and all information I'm going to give, we are going to learn tomorrow. So it will take around 1 hour to understand this creates in your copy and this submit option and backend table, this and all. But before that, everyone should be ready with your installation process. Those who are done with installation process, you go to downloads in Harsha trainings. There is a link called PG admin configuration. One link is there. If you go to downloads, you can just make a note of it. In the website downloads, if you do not know the name of the website, it will be there in the installation instructions document. You would have downloaded the software by this time and installed everyone. In the website downloads, PG admin database configuration, one link is there. I think that is 10th link. Okay. If you click on that link, it will download a Word document. There are steps to follow to configure the database. This is just a configuration. Your database installation is done or not? So while you install that batch file, it has installed Java JDK, it has installed Tomcat application server, it has installed database, and it has loaded some of the tables as well. So data, you are not performing database installation following the document. What you are performing is just your connecting to the client. From the client, you are connecting to the database. I'm sorry. Already database is created or not? Database installed, environment installed, client environment, database created, tables are loaded, which has been done while your installation process. Now this document, if you follow, you should be able to make a connection to the database from that client environment. If you blindly follow the document, you should be able to do that without any issues. Make sure you follow the document closely before you do start that configuration steps. Okay, fine. You can wind up for today. We'll continue tomorrow to understand this. In the meantime, after you complete this business requirement, you go ahead and configure your database connections from the PG admin environment, which you have installed while installing Vega. Okay, fine. You can wind up for today. Thank you for joining everyone. Any questions?
We'll see tomorrow. Last question.
Before we start the class, you have to ask me any questions that you have. Otherwise, you can give a message in WhatsApp group. You can go inside or you can use the room. Nobody can tell the washroom. Meer WhatsApp group lo unnara? Mee peru? Praveen. Okay. ఫ్రేమ్వర్క్ లో చేస్తాను మీరు నేను డాక్యుమెంట్స్ పంపిస్తాను ఐ హోప్ ఎవ్రీవన్ ఇస్ రిసీవింగ్ ద డాక్యుమెంట్స్ ఎవ్రీవన్ హూ హాస్ జాయిన్డ్ ఫర్ 7 o'clock బ్యాచ్ ప్లీజ్ క్విక్లీ ఎక్సెప్ట్ ద మీటింగ్ థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ఫర్ జాయినింగ్ 565 అదే మీన్ See, if it is combination of integer and text, you have to give it text only. Always it is text. Anything which is combination is a text, right? Any technology is same.
Thanks, Asha.
Okay, you can, everyone can exit the meeting. So those who have joined for 7 o'clock, we will talk to you later. Leela, are you there?
Yes, sir, I'm Leela.
who is Kavya? Someone joined with the name Kavya. Who is that? Okay, what are we working on? Sagar, are you there? Okay. So we were working on Google deployment now. That is completed. Okay. Let's talk about what case management. Ticket did we work on? Ticket. We'll complete that small portion of exercise as well. Otherwise, it's like I have skipped it. We'll complete ticket and then we'll talk about case management. So generally, in an activity, can you jump from one flow, one step to another step? Can we jump or not? Is there any video for a ticket? It is there. You can work on it, man. It is very simple. Just write. It will not take more than 10 minutes. Just note down. Watch a video about ticket. Same requirement you do. Implement. Okay. Then I'll jump on to case management, which is important for us. Watch a video about ticket. In YouTube channel, it is available. 563. Yeah? We'll work on case management. 5/63/8 to 9 March 18. Already case management videos are there, full videos, but still let's go ahead and talk about it.